Good morning, children. In the last class, we discussed about permutations, isn't it? Permutations means we discussed about the arrangements, in how many ways we can arrange, in how many ways we can arrange the letters of the word, isn't it? And it is given by the formula NPR is equal to N factorial by N minus R factorial. It is given by NPR is equal to N factorial by N minus R factorial. Okay. Now let's do few more questions in permutation. Write the question. Write this question. The last question we have discussed is, okay, how many words we can frame with all the alphabets I's together, isn't it? How many words can be formed using the letters of the word Mississippi with alphabets I's together? Okay, similar question only. Now we are going to discuss it again. Write the question. Find the number of eight letter arrangements that can be made. Find the number of eight letter arrangements that can be made from the letters of the word daughter. Okay, daughter, daughter.
Ma'am, can you repeat the question?
Yes, I'll repeat it. Find the number of different eight letter arrangements. Find the number of different eight letter arrangements. Find the number of different eight letter arrangements that can be made. Find the number of different eight letter arrangements that can be made from the letters of the word daughter. That can be made from the letters of the word daughter. That can be made from the letters of the word daughter. So that first one, all the vowels are together. Second one, all the vowels are not together. Find the number of different eight letter arrangements that can be made from the letters of the word daughter. First one, so that all vowels are together. And second one, all vowels do not occur together. How to do this? Let's recall how to do this one. Tell me how you did this one. All vowels are together. How to do this? All vowels should come together, isn't it? So first you look at, first we will find out. This one we used to do it in three steps, isn't it? First one, you find the total words can be formed. Total words can be formed using the letters of the word daughter. Okay, you take the daughter. How many letter words can be formed using the letters of the word daughter? So count and see. Total, how many alphabets are here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So it is a eight letter word. So in this, look at this, the letter D occurs only once. If you take the alphabet A, it occurs once. U, it occurs once. G comes once. Okay, so there is no repetition at all. All the letters are coming only once, isn't it? R is one. So total again here, 3, 6, 7, 8. We'll get 8. So how many words can be formed? So total words will be 8 factorial by, all the alphabet are coming one time, 1 factorial into 1 factorial into etc. 1 factorial, which will be same as 8 factorial. Find out the value of 8 factorial. What is the value of 8 factorial? So we know 6 factorial is 120, isn't it? 5 factorial, 6 factorial, like that you find out. What is 5 factorial, 6 factorial? 5 factorial is it 120? 6 factorial is? Yes, find out what is the value. Yes, Pranav, I think you are ready with the answer.
No, ma'am.
No, do it. Eight factorial, we can write this, isn't it? 5 into 6 into 7 into 8. At that day I told you have to learn, you'll be thorough with 5 factorial. You should learn by heart up to 5 factorial. So what is 5 factorial? 5, value of 5 factorial is
120
into 6 sevens are 42 into 8. Now simplify and write the answer. Okay, is it okay, children? Now, what is our aim? Now look at the second part. What do you have to do here? Okay, we want to find how many words are there with vowels together. How many words are there with vowels together? How to find? Yes, children, please turn on. Roseanne, yes. So we find out the total permutation. So what is the answer? What is the answer, Vinay?
40,320.
40,320. Yes, correct. It is 40,320. Now look at the second part. We want to find all the vowels occurring together. Okay, we consider the word daughter. We want to find all the vowels together. So how to do this one? How we will be doing this one? We want the vowels to be together. So what we will do, we take the vowels. Listen, children. We take all the vowels together and we will consider it as a single unit. We take the vowels together and we will consider it as a single unit. If you look at the word daughter. Okay, you look at the word daughter. Okay, so which all the vowels? So, okay, if I take the daughter, yes. So, which all the vowels will come together? We make the vowels as a single unit. So, D, A is the vowel, then U, G is not a vowel, isn't it? Then, tell me, the next one is H, T, E, R. Is it okay? How we are writing this? We group the vowels together. We group the vowels together and we consider this as a single unit. Okay? So look at the words now. D, A, U, G, H, T, E, R. From here, the letter D. Look at this word, daughter. The letter D occurs how many times, Akshay? How many times the letter D occurs? Only once. If you look at the word A, U, E together, that one also occurs once. G, it occurs once. H occurs once. T occurs once. R occurs once. So now count and see, it is a, okay, it is a word containing how many letters? How many letters are present? We consider A, U, E as a single word, isn't it? As a single alphabet. Now, how many letters are present? Yes, Aman, tell me.
Six.
Six, yes, correct. It is six. Okay, we consider A, U, E as a single unit, as a single alphabet. So, total there are six alphabets. Now, you find out the total permutations. So, what will be the total permutation? There is no repetition, isn't it? There is no repetition. So, what will be the answer? No repetition means we write the total on the top. 6 factorial by 1 factorial into 1 factorial into each word, each letter occurs only once. Into 1 factorial into 1 factorial into 1 factorial into 1 factorial. Okay, each letter occurs once. So, 6 factorial by 1 factorial, 1 factorial, etc. Into, it is not over. What do you have to do? You have to look at the arrangement of the word A-U-E. Look at the arrangement of the word A-U-E. Okay, if you look at the word A-U-E, how many alphabets are there? How many alphabets are there? Akshay, A, U, E.
Three.
Three alphabets and in three places. Three alphabets in three places. That means what is the formula? What do you have to calculate? Three alphabets in three places. Arranging three alphabets in three places means? Yes, Pranav.
I don't know.
Don't know. See, listen, in the last class we discussed about permutations. Okay. Suppose we have n elements. Suppose we have n elements. Okay. And suppose we have three objects. Suppose I'm going to select three objects from this n and I'm going to arrange it out of n objects. I'm going to select three objects. Okay. And we are going to arrange it. What is the formula we discussed? Out of n objects, suppose we select three objects. Yes. Is it permutation or combination?
NPR.
Yes, very good, Vinay. It is NPR. Is it okay, Pranav? Out of n objects, suppose I'm going to arrange R objects, means we denote that as NPR. Okay. Out of n objects, suppose we arrange R objects, we denote it as NPR. Suppose 10 alphabets are there. Suppose we are given with 10 alphabets. Okay. From the 10 alphabets, okay, 10 different alphabets. Okay, it is okay, it should not be repeated. No repetition should be there. All the elements should be differentiated. Suppose we are given with 10 different alphabets. First 10 alphabets. I'm going to arrange two alphabets. What is the formula?
10P2.
Ah, yes. Now is it okay? From 10 objects, we can arrange two. We can arrange two at a time means in how many ways we can arrange? It is 10P2. Now look at here, AUE. We want to arrange the AUE. So in AUE, how many alphabets are there? There are
three
alphabets. And we want to arrange all the three letters. So three letters in three places. Three letters in three places means Krishna Gandhi?
Three factorial, three P.
Yes, very correct. It is 3P3, which is, she gave the answer also, it is 3 factorial. What is NPN? NPN, Roseanne? NPN is? NPN. It is? NPN is N factorial. NPN is N factorial. So what will be 3P3? 3 factorial. So we will get this as 6 factorial into 3 factorial. Now find out what is 6 factorial. What's the value of 6 factorial? Yes, Pravinay?
720.
Yes, 720 into 3 factorial is? Pranav, what is 3 factorial?
6.
So now multiply this and find the answer. 720 into 6. Yes. Abdul Aman, what is 720 into 6? It is 4,320. The first case also you got that?
Yes. Yes, ma'am.
So, look at them, you check this first part, is it correct? Others check your answers. Both you will get means there is, okay, here you have to subtract it. 5 factorial into 6 into 7 into 8.
First one.
Second one also you get 40,320.
4,320.
Second one is 4,320. Both are same. What is 5 factorial, children? This 120, isn't it? What is 6 factorial? This 720. 720 into 3 factorial means it is 6. Okay. So now what about the 8 factorial? Find out what is the value of 8 factorial. It is 5 factorial into 6 into 7 into 8. Yes, 40,320. Okay, it is 40,320. Check it, children. It is 5 factorial into 6 into 7 into 8. So 120 into 6 into 7 into 8. What is the answer? 120 into 7, 6 are 42 into 8. What is the answer, Roseanne? Yes, we can't hear Roseanne.
I'm doing it.
Doing. Okay. Do it and give the answer. What is the answer, Pranav? Total number of words we can form is?
40,320.
Total number of words we can frame is 40,320. And in the second step, what we did? We take all the vowels together. And when we take all the vowels together, the number of words framed is 4,320. Now, what is asked? What is asked in the question? Read the question. What is asked in the first part? Read the question, Akshay.
Find the number of 8-letter arrangements that can be made from letters of the word daughter. D-A-U-G-H-T-E-R.
So that, what is the first part asked?
All vowels are together.
So the first one is all vowels are together. So, how many words can be formed with all the vowels together? What is the answer? With all vowels together, we take vowels as a single unit. With a single unit, how many words we got? What is the answer? It is 4,320. Now, look at the second part. What is the second part asked? What is the second one? All vowels do not occur together. So, all vowels do not occur together. So, this one, how will you calculate? How to calculate this one? Yes, Krishna Gandhi?
Mom will subtract the first.
Yes.
Equation by the second.
Yes. We will be subtracting. Okay. We will be subtracting from the total. Okay. So all vowels do not occur together is same as total arrangements. From the total arrangements, we subtract number of words with vowels together. Okay. We subtract total arrangement minus number of words with vowels together. So, what is the total arrangement? In the beginning we calculated. What is the total arrangement? It is? Total arrangement, the answer is 40,320. This 40,320 minus 4,320. Subtract it and give your answer. 40,320. Yes.
36,000.
It is 36,000. Others, check it. Is it correct? Vinay?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Yes, it is correct. 36,000. So, okay, the number of words that can be framed without the vowels occurring together is 36,000. It is 36,000. Okay. Okay, children. Is it okay? Now, once again, go through it. How we did this question? The question is, the given word is daughter. We want to find how many words can be framed with the vowels together and the vowels not together. So what we did? First, we calculated the total number of permutations without considering any restriction. We considered all the alphabets and we considered all the alphabets in the word daughter, no restrictions on that, and then we calculated the total permutation. To find the vowels together, what we did then, you take the vowels, look at the vowels present in the word daughter. So the vowels present in the daughter are A, U, E. We take it as a single unit. We consider it as a single alphabet. So when we consider this as a single alphabet, we get the total number of alphabets present is 6. And we find the permutation. So it is 6 factorial into, we have to look at the arrangement of A, U, E. A, U, E is a 3-letter word. We can arrange it in six, how many ways? 6 P3 ways, isn't it? First letter we can fix and we can arrange like this. So we have 6 P3 ways. 6 P3 means it is 3 factorial. On simplifying, we get the answer as 4320. So how many words can be formed? How many words can be formed with the vowels not together means from the total we subtract number of words with the vowels together. Is it okay? Now let's do one more question in that model. Write the question. Find the number of words that can be framed. Find the number of words that can be framed using the letters of the word. Using the letters of the word Monday. Using the letters of the word Monday. Using the letters of the word Monday. First one. Okay. Monday. Using the letters of the word Monday. So that first one, all vowels occur together. All vowels occur together. Second one, vowels not occurring together. Vowels not occurring together. Okay. How many words can be formed using the letters of the word Monday? Or how many arrangements can be made using the letters of the word Monday? Okay, with alphabets together and alphabets not together. What is the first step? How you solve this? What is the first step? What do you have to calculate here first?
Total words.
Yes, we want to find the total number of words. Find out the total number of words. So first you count and see how many alphabets are present. How many alphabets are present? In Monday, it is a 6-letter word, isn't it? And look at the occurrence of each alphabet. So the alphabet M occurs how many times?
Once.
If you take the alphabet O, it also occurs once. N, it occurs once. D, it occurs once. A, it occurs once. Y, it occurs once. Therefore, what is the total permutation? Yes, Aman is there? Aman? No. Yes. Krishna Gandhi, give the answer, Krishna Gandhi.
720.
So give the steps. Answer is correct. Okay, give the step.
6 factorial by 1 factorial into 1 factorial into 6.
Yes. Okay, correct. So it is 720. So this is the first step. Okay, whenever we are asked such questions, we will be solving this in three steps. First step, you find out the total permutation. This is the first step. Completed this one? Is it over? Now, what is the second step? In second step, what do you have to calculate? Vinay. In second step?
Vowels occur together.
Yes, we take the vowels together as a single unit. Okay. So we take the vowels as a single unit. Okay. So now, previous. Okay. So the same word we are considering here, Monday. We take the vowels together, isn't it? That is the second step. So you take, you check with the alphabets. M, it occurs separate, O separate, N, D, A is a vowel. So we join this. And Y. Now count and see. M occurs one times, OA occurs one time, N occurs one time, D, Y. So what is the total alphabets here? OA we consider as a single unit. Yes, Pranav, what is the answer? How many alphabets?
Five.
So what will be the total arrangement here? So the total arrangement is 5 factorial by, shall we stop with this? Is it over? Can we stop with this? 5 factorial by 1 factorial, is it over? What do you have to do? You have to look at the arrangement of the word AU, isn't it? You have to look at the arrangement of the word AU. So AU is a two-letter word. Two letters in two places. Two letters in two places. Pranav, in how many ways?
5P2.
No. See, look at this. AU, you consider only the vowels. You take that vowels part.
2P2.
No need to consider the whole thing. The whole thing we wrote. Okay, look at here. Okay, Pranav. Look at here. Here it is a five-letter word. So for this five letters, we wrote this one. Now, you look at the vowel combination. Only for those combination, we have to check again. After writing for the whole word, you have to look at for the vowels separately. So if you look under the vowels part, okay, if you look at the part unit containing vowels, how many alphabets are present in that vowel?
Two.
And okay, that two vowels will be arranging it in two places, isn't it? So what is the answer?
2 factorial.
It's 2 factorial. 2P2. 2P2, which is 2 factorial. So into 2 factorial. So answer is 5 factorial into 2 factorial. What is the answer? Vinay, calculate and give the answer, Vinay.
214.
240, very good. So this second part gives how many words are there with vowels together. How many words are there with vowels together? But what you have to calculate here? How many words are there with, okay, with vowels not together? How to do this? How many words are there with vowels not together? How to do this?
Subtract.
Subtract. Yes, we'll be subtracting it from the total part. We'll be subtracting it from the total part. So, number of words. Number of words with vowels not together is equal to total arrangements minus number of words with vowels together. Number of words with vowels together. So that will be same as total arrangement. What is the total arrangement, Roseanne?
720
minus 240 subtract it, you'll get the answer. What is the answer?
480.
Is it clear, children? Is it okay? Is it okay, children? Is this part okay? I'll give similar questions as homework. Okay, try to do this. Okay, you can do it by yourself. No need of homework. Instead of that, what you can do? You can take any word. You take the word dictionary. You can take some lengthy word and try to solve it. Okay, you can take some lengthy word and you can solve it. Okay, write these two questions as homework. Write down. Find the number of words that can be formed. Find the number of words that can be formed using the letters of the word. Using the letters of the word. First one, apple. Okay, your second one, application. Application. Okay, so that first one, all vowels are together. All vowels are together. Second one, all vowels are not together. All vowels are together and all vowels are not together. Is it okay? Note the homework questions. Do this, okay? And we'll be discussing the answers in the next class. Okay? Okay, children. With this, we wind up today's session. Thank you.